All right, it's time to check out Big Scoob Walk the Line featuring Recognize. I didn't recognize him. I've been seeing that in my comment section. Somebody's going to put it in there, I bet. Talk a little bit more on Big Scoob. When I first started this channel, people was like, man, you should check out strange music artists. So I went on my own and was just clicking on videos on YouTube. I just put in strange music artists. And that's where I seen Ritz. That's where I seen Big Scoob. I didn't see Mayday at the time or Stevie Stone. That's where I seen Seth's Crew, which I didn't know they were actually a crew. I basically just saw Not an Average Joe by Yubi and watched it. I had no idea he was actually part of a crew. You know what I mean? So, and then I saw Big Scoop. And I'm the music, I looked at two videos of his, and it just seemed like trap music to me. Like, that's what it seemed like. It just seemed like trap music to me. So people was like, he doesn't really do trap music, he does like gangster music. Well, I did a video a while back, probably like last week, that to me, gangster music and trap music is the same. And the reason why I say that is because I come from an era where rappers were claiming to be gangsters and they rapped about stuff in the trap. Now, for some of you all who don't know music past 2000, you know, some of you all who are not familiar with the more 90s version of music, there's been different eras in music that have come along. At around 2008, there was an era, I want to say like from 2006, maybe even 05 to 12, where everyone was D-boys. Okay? Like everybody was picking up the D-boy mantle. So from like 6 to 12, about a 6-year run, everyone was claiming to be D-boys or putting in or moving work or whatever. Okay, that kind of brought about the trap style of music where people were just associating trap music with D-boys. It's not the case. If there's anybody out there who listened to older music before it was considered trap music, before there was even considered gangster music, which gangster music was more considered in the 90s, where everybody was considering themselves to be gangster. But they still rapped about issues in the trap. Now, the trap is not having to do with just drugs. The trap is the environment itself, okay? If you ever lived in a trap, or if you're still living in a trap, you know exactly what I'm talking about. It's the environment. It's called a trap for a reason. Basically, when you try to get out, it's like a trap. Okay, things try to keep you from breaking free, whether it be drug dealing, gang fights, you know, police brutality, low income to no income jobs. You feel me? It's considered a trap. Those are the issues in which a lot of artists back in the 90s who were considered themselves to be gangsta rapped about trap issues because they were actually from the trap. Fast forward years and years later, you get this dope boy style, and then you get this considered trap music. We can debate this all day long if we wanted to, but the era in which I come from with music, it's if you were pushing gangsta music, you were normally rapping about stuff in the trap, which is the environment. And if me coming from a trap, I could see the very things that were being talked about in the song in my environment. And we basically just called it a trap. When it became about just drugs and trap music, I don't know. I didn't get the memo. You know what I'm saying? Because I live in a trap. So drugs was already a part of the issue of being in the trap. So maybe if you're looking at it from an outside view of you not actually living in a trap and you're just listening to this music and they're talking about drugs and you want to associate that with trap music, that's fine. But if you live in a trap, there's a lot more elements about a trap besides drugs. Just want y'all to know. So the two songs I looked at, I was like, man, it's like trap music. So I didn't really pay him much attention, but people were saying he has good songs. So I am not opposed at all at looking at someone's music when they got good music. It's just the feel I got from him when I first heard him. And there was just two random songs. I don't even really remember the names of them, to be honest with you, because I was just checking them out. And then about the first 20 seconds, I was like, eh, I don't think I'll listen to this on my own time. You know what I'm saying? Like, sound like trap music. And that's just what I said to myself. So, this is supposed to be a good one. We gonna see what it's about. And here we go. His hands was up.
Heavy head as I sit and write. My mental scattered everywhere. My thoughts are all jumbled up. A clusterfuck in despair. My life is such a bitch to bear. The smoke seems to never clear. Taking calls, helping y'all. But when I fall, nobody's there. They tell me life ain't ever fair. Tell me that my heart is rare. Tell me how I'm living is forgiven if I practice prayer. Wishing I was unaware. Living life without a care. Rolling through the hills on bad wheels. I ain't got a spare. Fighting, but I'm ill prepared. A titan trying to hold my square. Enlightened, kind of frightened with the sights as I become. Aware. Hold the elevator, second thought, I'ma take the stairs. Struggle as I'm getting there, embrace the journey, I ain't scared. What they selling, I can't hear it, I'm rebelling, that's my spirit. Kinda groggy, not the clearest, pouring whiskey, something serious. A penny for my thoughts, then all these doubts is bout. Continuing this walk, just hoping I ain't lost.
I got trouble on my mind, they keep telling me that it'll be just fine. I'm walking the line.
News on this TV, depressing as a motherfucker. Thinking it's just TV, but it's real as a motherfucker. Shit didn't really hit the fan. Everybody show their hand. Choose a side where you stand. Plant your feet, be a man. Liberty and justice for all, like Mama Yates say. Niggas, we ain't fucking with y'all. I'm hearing them say. It's cool if you don't fuck with me. Just let me know what it's about to be so I can be the monster you devils make me out to be. My country to the thee, we the brave and the free. But it's clear that you lied to me in different times, but we ain't free. From slave to the White House, getting paid in a nice house. You can stay, watch what you say, behave, keep a tight mouth. Your opinions when it's given, just be thankful how you living. But my soul ain't for sale, only God can do my bidding. In a country built on violence, ain't surprised that you violent. Just surprised how you hide it and despise how we slide.
I got trouble on my mind, they keep telling me.
He's speaking real on this song. Alright, this was a good song. I didn't know, recognize the thing till now. Grown kind of fond of that strange music at the end of videos, not gonna lie. That was a good song. That was a good message. That is, I'm honestly gonna say, for those of us who are just not straight up rebelling, that is probably a good message for a good percentage of people. They're walking this line. they want to stay civil, but at the same time, the the over amount of evidence of how we're treated is just, it's just becoming too evident to where some people are just on this line, like they're trying to stay civil, but at the same time, it's like all it takes is like maybe one or two more incidents, and then they're gonna tip one way or another. You know what I'm saying? Like, that is a good message. That is a super good message. If you all have any other songs you might want to see me react to from Big Scoob, you know I'll do it. You know what I'm saying? You know that I'll do it. There's no problem. None at all. He's Strange Music Family anyway. I did not know Wekanize could sing. Surprise! But you guys did say he's part of a actual band. He's not just a rapper, he's actually part of a band. Like, there's like 7 of them or 8 of them, something like that. So that doesn't really surprise me when you work in a more of a band environment. You can rap and sing. Kind of makes sense. That was good. You guys let me know what you thought about it. How many of y'all walking the line? How many of y'all walking the line? I don't really consider myself walking the line. I've made my opinions very clear on these videos. Very, very clear. I'm reading a book right now called The Rise of the Warrior Cop. I'm only like 20 pages in, and I'm already beginning to see where all this crap came from. So it's starting to make sense a little bit. And this is why I read books. I read books because understanding the past of something lets you know what you're dealing with in the present and what it's going to be in the future. Because we always just do this. Nobody wants to admit it. Everybody thinks all this nice new technology we have means that we're actually advancing. But you sit here and tell me, when have we actually had nothing but peace in our country? Nothing in peace in our world. I'll wait. Anyway, that's going to do it for this reaction. And your boy is Nixon.